What's up, guys? Welcome back to the Gaming Careers YouTube channel, where we teach you how to live stream and how to create content within the gaming niche. Now, a little over a year ago, when this channel was super small, I created a video teaching people how to live stream on Twitch using OBS Studio and, you know, what settings you needed. And I didn't know at the time, but when I created the video, it instantly became my most popular video, and it has remained my most popular video ever since. And I think at the time of recording, it's taught nearly 700,000 people how to stream to Twitch. Now, with that video being a little over a year old, it is also a little bit outdated. It has a lot of relevant information in it still, but it's a bit outdated, really for three main reasons. Firstly, OBS has had, you know, 20 new versions since I made that video, so there's been lots of updates, including a nifty little auto configuration wizard to help get your settings right. Secondly, Twitch has heavily invested in their infrastructure all around the world and have updated their broadcasting guidelines and, you know, what settings you should use to stream since I created the video. And thirdly, graphics cards companies like AMD and Nvidia have also heavily invested into developing chips that they include with their newest graphics cards that help take the encoding process away from the CPU. So for those three reasons, the guide is a little outdated, and I thought today I would do a 2018 version. Now, as with the previous video, we will be going over the key settings. So things like which Twitch server to stream to, what bitrate, what frame rate, what resolution, but we will be using the OBS configuration wizard, which wasn't included when I made the last video, and that's gonna help set up some of our settings for us straight away. So if you're ready, let's dive in. So first things first, let's download and install OBS Studio by heading to the website, which I've included down in the description below. You'll just need to expand the description to see it, and I've also included a link on screen now. Once you arrive at the website, you need to choose your operating system that you're going to be installing for between Windows, Mac, or Linux. I'll be installing for Windows, but since OBS Studio is multi-platform, all the settings we cover in this video are appropriate for the Mac and Linux versions as well. Install the application as you normally would and launch OBS when installation has finished. When it launches, it should look something like this. Now, for those of you that are completely new to OBS, this may look a little bit hectic, but it's really just made up of a few different sections. Firstly, up top, this is the stream preview. This shows exactly what OBS Studio is sending out over the internet to Twitch. Down in the bottom left, you have the scenes and sources sections. Scenes are effectively just different screens that you can switch to display something different to your viewers. Typically, people will have, you know, at least a game scene, a be right back scene, and maybe a starting soon scene. Sources are individual elements that you want to display in each scene. So for example, in our game scene, we might want to show the game, that's one source, as well as the webcam, that's another source, and maybe, you know, a recent subscriber, and that's a third source. In the middle, at the bottom, we have the audio mixer. This is where we can see and change the audio levels of all the different audio sources. So for example, our desktop audio source or our microphone source. To the right of that, we have the scene transitions, which is just basically a way of choosing how you want the transition to show between two scenes. Finally, on the right in the bottom, you have some controls for starting and stopping your stream or recording, as well as getting into your settings. Below that, you also have some little info panels showing you how long you've been live for, how long you've been recording for, as well as your CPU usage and your frame rate. Before diving straight into the settings and the configuration wizard, the first thing that we want to do is set up our profile and our scene collection. If you look up at the top title bar here, you will see that we have profile untitled and scenes untitled. And that is because we haven't set up any profiles or scene collections yet. OBS allows you to have multiple different profiles, each with their own set of settings, which is super useful if you're going to be streaming to different accounts from time to time. All we'll do here is we'll rename the default one by going up to profile and selecting rename. I'd recommend naming this whatever your channel name is and the streaming platform, so it's easy to make sure you have the right profile selected when you're using OBS. So for me, that's going to be Gaming Careers-Twitch, because I'm going to be streaming using this profile to my Gaming Careers Twitch channel. OBS also allows you to have many different scene collections, each with their own set of scenes and sources inside. This is super useful if you're going to be streaming different games from time to time and you want to have a different looking stream for each game. Again, we're just going to be selecting scene collection, rename, and rename it to whatever makes sense for your stream. I'm going to be naming mine gaming scenes because I also have collections for podcasts and other shows that I do. Now, if we look back up at the top title bar again, you should see that we now have our profile and scene selection set up properly. In the previous video that I recorded last year, at this point we had to dive deep into the settings of OBS and start testing our connection. But at some point in the last year, OBS added the auto configuration wizard that aims to test your computer and your internet connection to Twitch or YouTube or whatever platform you end up choosing, with the aim of setting a lot of these complex settings like bitrate, server location, resolution, and frame rate for you. Now, although these settings that get set may not be bang on perfect, they certainly give you a very, very good starting point for your stream settings. So to run the wizard, we come up to Tools and select Auto Configuration Wizard. A new window will appear which will ask you if you want to optimize your settings for streaming, with recording being a secondary, or if you are just optimizing for recording. Since this is the ultimate guide to streaming with OBS, I recommend that you guys choose the first option and press Next. The next screen allows you to select your base resolution or your canvas resolution and your FPS preferences. Let's start with the base resolution. This should be set to the resolution that your game is being run at. So if you're playing on a 1920 by 1080 monitor and you play your game at that resolution also, then you should select 1920 by 1080 here. It's worth noting that this isn't necessarily the same as the resolution that you will eventually stream at. OBS may advise to scale down your stream to something like 1280 by 720, but it's important to set it here to what your monitor and, more importantly, what your game resolution is. Since my monitor is 1440p, I will be selecting that resolution here. The second option is your frames per second, or FPS, and that allows you to choose a number of different options as what you'd like to stream at. You can select some hard values like 30 and 60, or there's also these other two preference-based options. The first one, either 30 or 60, but prefer 60 when possible. This is for people that want to prioritize getting 60 frames per second over their resolution. Whereas the either 60 or 30 but prefer higher resolution, this is for people that want to prioritize getting a higher resolution over the 60 frames per second frame rate. So which of these options should you actually choose? Well, that's completely up to you. Do you want the smoothest possible video or the highest detailed resolution? For fast-paced games such as first-person shooters or racing games, I would recommend prioritizing 60 FPS, but feel free to choose either option. Just remember, the OBS wizard will only recommend 60 FPS or the higher resolution if it deems your computer and your connection are good enough to be able to handle it. Once you've decided, you can click Next to move on to the stream information step. This is where you're going to be choosing which platform you wish to stream to, as well as entering your stream key. Firstly, stream type allows you to choose if you are going to be using a streaming service or if you want to be using a custom streaming server. Since we're all streaming to Twitch here, we'll be choosing streaming service. Next, we'll get a drop down of all the different current services that OBS supports. So Twitch, YouTube, Mixer, Facebook, they're all in there, and we're going to be selecting Twitch. Next, we need to enter our stream key. So this is the private key that we can get from our Twitch account, and it's the only thing required by OBS to allow you to stream to that Twitch account. So this is a private key that should be kept private. To get the key, you can click the little link in OBS to open up your web browser to the right page where the stream key is shown. If you aren't already logged into Twitch on your browser, then you'll obviously need to log in before you can get your stream key. You can also always access your stream key by going to the Twitch website, then going to your dashboard, clicking Channel under Settings, and then finally clicking on your stream key. Twitch reiterates that you shouldn't be sharing this key with anybody else. Obviously, I'm going to be showing my key here in this video, but there's also an option to reset your key, which I'll be clicking as soon as I finish making this video. So last time I did this, everyone was commenting, "Oh, you said you couldn't show your key," and you showed your key, but obviously I just reset it after I've made a video. Select the whole stream key and copy it. Head back to OBS and then paste it into the stream key box. The next two boxes should usually be left checked. The first one, which is prefer hardware encoding, means that OBS will try and use the GPU's dedicated encoder chip if it has one, which is usually preferable as it frees up your CPU, which should in theory help reduce stream issues. However, hardware encoding does also usually result in a lower quality encoding for streaming. I personally would recommend using the hardware encoding if you can and leaving this box checked. Obviously, if you're not sure whether or not your graphics card has the encoding chip, you can leave this box checked and OBS will check for you. But actually, the ideal setup would be for you to test both CPU encoding and GPU encoding on your stream and seeing which one you think makes better results in terms of quality as well as in terms of the system performance impact. The second box, which is estimate bitrate with a bandwidth test, this just means that OBS will perform a test to some local Twitch servers to try and find an ideal bitrate that you can stream at. Once you're happy, you can click Next and OBS will begin to start performing its configuration tests. What it is doing is streaming some random data at various different resolutions, bit rates, and frame rates to Twitch servers without actually going live to try and work out what your system and your connection is capable of. This test is pretty quick, takes less than a minute, and when it is complete, you should get a window showing the test results. Take a look at all the different settings that OBS has recommended, what resolution the output stream will be at, as well as what bitrate and what FPS. Clicking Apply Settings will mean that OBS will then apply these settings to the current profile. I just want to reiterate something and make it really clear that this is OBS's estimate as to what the ideal settings for your setup would be. Most people at some point in their streaming career are going to have to jump into the settings window and change one or more of these values to keep things stable. All of these settings that have been applied can be found if you click the Settings button here on the right and look in the relevant tab. The Stream tab is where your streaming service and stream key are. The Output tab is where the video bitrate, the encoder, and the recording options are. And finally, the Video tab is where the output resolution and FPS options are. There's also some tabs for general audio, hotkeys, and advanced for you to have a look at if your heart so desires. The final thing we need to do before we start streaming is to add a scene and a source. Let's start by renaming this default scene called Scene by right-clicking it and choosing Rename. I'm going to call this scene Game since it's going to be the scene that has my gameplay in. Next, move across to the Sources panel and click the plus icon. This shows all the different types of sources that you can add to each scene, things like text, image overlays, webcams, browser windows, and all sorts of other things. To keep things super simple for this video, we're just going to be selecting Game Capture since we want to start by capturing our game. Make sure that you have your game running at the same time as setting this up so that we can make sure that it's captured properly. Name it whatever you want. It doesn't actually matter what you name it, but it helps to identify each source. You know, once you're further on in setting up your stream, you're going to have many different sources in each scene, and it's going to really help if you have them named properly. I'm actually going to be leaving mine as Game Capture since this is always going to be the source that captures my game, no matter if I change game. Once the Game Capture window has opened, it gives you a number of different options for its mode. If you always play your games in full screen rather than something like windowed or borderless, you should be able to leave the mode on Capture any full screen application. This just means that OBS is always going to find the full screen application and choose to use that as its source. However, for some games that doesn't always work, or maybe you're running your games in a windowed or a borderless mode, in which case change the mode to capture a specific window and then select the correct window you want to capture from the next dropdown. Hopefully you should then see the stream preview update with your captured game, and that is basically the very beginnings of building your stream layout and design. At this point, I'd love to recommend you watch my video on adding more sources to OBS. It covers adding games, webcams, overlays, and text, as well as covering various issues that some game capture methods suffer from, such as the black screen bug. I've linked the video down in the description once again, but also you should be able to click a little link in the top right corner. I also have a whole playlist on how to do various things on OBS. If you're new to this channel, it's definitely worth subscribing and having a look around at all the cool things that we've learned how to do for your OBS Studio stream. Thanks so much for watching, and hopefully you have enjoyed this 2018 version of how to stream to Twitch. Another video that I'm just going to recommend if you're having any issues with your stream, I do have a video on Twitch Inspector, which is a way of being able to analyze what's going wrong with your stream and helping decide what settings to change. So definitely check out that video again down in the description if you're having any issues. It's really interesting for me how much easier this has become. It's become so much easier to set up your stream with things like the auto configuration wizard, and there's so much more detailed information that Twitch is actually giving out. So it's nowhere near as long of a setup process, and hopefully you've been able to follow along and have something that you're happy with. Finally, I want to finish just by thanking again my Patreons. They're supporting the creation of these videos for the whole of the gaming careers community. So I'd like to say a massive thanks to these people here for supporting the channel. And if you haven't yet joined our Discord, we have, you know, over 100 members now, all in our Discord channel talking about how to improve streams and networking and all these kind of things, as well as just the general, you know, jokes and memes. So if you haven't joined the Discord yet, please do. If you would like to also become a Patreon, I would really love it if you would go and check out my Patreon page, again linked in the description below. There's loads of perks that you can sign up for, such as, you know, getting shout outs in this video, but also things like stream promotion in Discord or hosted on my website, as well as various other things that I'm offering. So please do go and have a look at my Patreon and consider supporting if you have found these guides helpful. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I will see subscribers in the next video. Peace.